Putting it all together. So currently we are in section 8 and we are about to check out the third video, that is the last video of this section. So how to define a class in Dart? Well, a class is a blueprint to create objects out of it. For example, on the right we have a class of student that has some field variables or the instance variable, and we have some other code. Such as, this is the syntax to define the default constructor in Dart. And please note that a constructor has always the name of the class, followed by the parenthesis. It looks like a function, but it does not have a return type. So this is the default constructor, and in Dart we have a special kind of constructor known as the named constructor. Such as, here we have given the name of the constructor as named1. And within the same class, you can define as many named constructor as you want to. It is totally up to your wish. And within the parenthesis, if you want, you can pass some parameter. And here as well, you can pass some parameter and make it as parameterized constructor. And within the class, you can have as many functions you want to, such as the behavior of study or sleep or walk or eat, something like that. So in short, these two variables within the class are known as the instance variable or the field variables. And these are the constructor. And down below within this method, if you notice, I have defined one more variable of integer marks. Well, this variable is known as the local variable because this variable is only confined within this method, not outside this method. So that is why I am calling this as the local variable. And now on the left, if you notice, we have defined the objects such as student1 and student2. And we have assigned some value to the ID and name in both the case, right? Now this variable S1 and S2, these are known as the reference variables because they are referring to some object. And on the right, we have student constructor, which is being used to create objects in Dart. So always remember, S1 is not the object. It is known as the reference variable. And on the right, we are creating one object. And same in the case of student2 as well. And now proceeding, whatever you see in our day-to-day life, you can create a class out of that. For example, suppose you see a dog, so you can create a class out of dog. Similarly, a car can be a class, the person can be a class, and the student can be a class like we saw in our example. And in the end, suppose we have a landscape, so that can also be a class. Similarly, any vehicle, a school, a company, a country, or a city, they all can be a class. So whatever, anything or everything that you see in your day-to-day life, you can create a class out of that. Just remember it. And then you can define the properties and also behavior of that particular class. Such as a dog can bark, a dog can run, a dog has a color or a breed. You can define as many properties you want to. So that's all for this video. So in this section, we have covered how to create class and objects, what are instance variables, how to define functions within a class, what are constructors and its types such as the default constructor, parameterized constructor, named constructor, and also the constant constructor. So we have covered all of these topics with valid examples. So let us continue our discussion on the object-oriented programming in the next section, as this was the getting started section. So see you all in the next section, and of course, thanks for watching. Have a nice day.